Hello everyone and welcome to my Unreal Engine 4 tutorial series on how to make a weapon system. The last video went too long, so I have to cut it down. So we are back with where we left previously. So as you can see, we can do this. As you can see, we can't do this equipping a weapon of this weapon pistol, and we can't equip this handgun. So we will do all these things now. So first open the weapon component. Now first open the weapon in hand, the in hand socket we have created previously. If you add any preview mesh in here, you can see any preview mesh. Let's check it out. You can see it is facing on the wrong way. I want this to face on the right way, so let me just set this rotation. Don't do for the location, but we will simply do for the rotation. Everything else is fine because we will do that dynamically. Where it was, the in hand. In hand, this way. So I'm happy with this because my meshes are not so well. And now on the open your master weapon object, and if you remember on the set weapon state, I want to set a state for my weapon when I equip in hand. So I will first simply go in here and control W to duplicate all this. Set collision profile to no collision for the interaction area as well as the weapon mesh. And mesh should be physics, should be not simulating. So control W to duplicate this three, as you can see, and add it to this in hand part. Let me just unpin this. Okay. Now what we want to do, the next part of attaching the sockets is the on the right position, because if I hit E, you can see it is not actually on the correct position, the handle. But before that, let's just complete that equipping and unequipping part, and then after just a small thing remains. So for the equipping and unequipping part, we have these three macros. So first go in the rifle one. So if it falls, then I want to unequip. So this equip, unequip, and I want to unequip. So yeah, what I want to unequip, the in hand weapon I want to unequip, and set it to false because I want to unequip it. And this would go to the full holster. Same way with the pistol, I want to simply unequip. Whoops. The weapon I want to unequip is the pistol, not a pistol, in the in hand weapon actually. In hand. And this would go to the pistol. Same way for the melee holster. Equipping and unequip. We haven't done the full part, so if you test from this, you will access a null value. So we will do that. We are about to complete this equipping and equipping, so don't worry. In hand weapon, I want to unequip this in hand weapon. And please follow this closely because the is validation is so much important. Otherwise, you will face the access none error. Okay. We have done this. Now what? Go to the event we made in the event graph. Yes. So first we are checking it none. Okay. Then we are checking if our weapon is equipped or not. If it's not equipped, then we want to equip it. If it is equipped, then what? Then I want to check. Oops. Hit branch. Then I want to check. Yeah, we already have one weapon in our hand. So what I will do? So first I want to check on based on this input. To get the input, first it should not is equal to the sheath. Otherwise, I don't want to follow any of this. Another condition is this weapon, not any, the weapon based on this. So get this one. Yes. We have made this weapon pure in the previous one. it should not equal to sheath weapon, because if it want to sheath, then we want to sheath the weapon. Then if we have a weapon in our hand, then I want to swap that weapon. If it folds, then I simply want to equip that weapon. So let's, for the folds part, I simply want to equip the weapon. Which weapon I want to equip? This one. And yeah, I want to equip it, so hit true. Wait, sorry, I don't want to equip it, I want to unequip it, and then I want to equip this guy. And yes, after thing, I will simply set this all to false, because I don't know which weapon we are unequipping. So I will set all to false, and it will eventually turn back to true respective weapons based on the slots. If it is a true part, then I want to swap weapon, and this is the last function of the equipment. So we have done here. So swap a weapon, this is the last function. And obviously a swap weapon has one input called the weapon. This would be a master weapon object reference hit component. We don't need any of this. Close. Yes, we need only event graph. So in here, let's just call out this swap weapon. And the weapon I want to interact with this guy. It compiles. So let's code everything of a swapping. So for the swap weapon, where should we go? Okay. So we have done this and this, this. Okay. So yeah, first things first, let's just get the slot. So get the slot based on the weapons. Let me just see a real quick. Okay, and the weapon would be this one. So I will promote this guy to a local variable, because I don't want to share this variable. I'm gonna call it the next, or let's say next weapon slot. And I will promote this guy to next weapon holster, a local variable of next weapon holster. Right. Now I need an in hand weapon, because I know we have an in hand weapon. This is why we are swapping. So I want to get the slot based on this guy also. And this would be also promoted to a local variable called in hand slot. And we need a holster, so in hand holster. Because we are actually swapping, so we need two values to swap between. Right? So what we'll do? First, I will attach my in hand weapon, what is in my in hand, to its respective holster. Whatever is in my hand, the weapon will go to whatever the holster it belongs. So attach to component where target is an actor. The attaching part, the target would be this hand, and the parent would be our mesh, player mesh. Okay. The socket would be in hand holster. Right? And set it to keep snap to target. So we are setting it back to our holster. Then let's set this in hand weapon state. So set weapon state to equipped, not dropped, equipped. and then I will simply set this in hand weapon to none. After setting it to none, I will simply set all the booleans to false because I don't know which weapon we are unequipping. Melee holster and rifle holster and pistol holster. And then simply I want to equip the weapon. So equip and unequip. So yeah. Do you want to equip a weapon? Yes. And the weapon would be the weapon. The weapon. This is a parameter, input parameter of this guy. This the weapon. It is this. Hit compile and save. We will do for the inputting part also 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 different weapons. But I think this is it. So let me check and hopefully this works. So yes, this is equipping. If I equip this, it is equipping in my hand and the AK-47 is going to my where the slot is belongs. If I equip this guy, then it is in my hand and all the, if I equip this guy, then we have followed a error. Okay. Primary slot, second pistol and melee slot. Okay, so it is for, whoops, 1, 2, 3. Yes, errors and warnings. So something happened terribly wrong. So let me see what, where we messed up. Swap. Okay, so the problem was in the equip unequip function, this one. So as you can see, after I don't want to equip, I simply want to set the in hand weapon to none because we don't have any weapon in our hand after unequipping it. So I will set this guy to none because otherwise it will say it's false. So let's now check it. Yep. Also, this is also equipping. If I hit this, I can do that. I can do this guy and yeah. So yeah, I can do anything. Okay, so finally it is working. Now what? Close this up because we have done all the things we need for the weapon system component except for one thing. The gun, this guy, it is not exactly positioned, the handle, but I want it to be exactly positioned where the handle is. And we will do it dynamically because if your gun is something that you downloaded from different resources, then all the artists think differently. So all the guns are different position. So it is not the best way to align a socket for this. So I'll simply close all the two things, weapon component, master weapon, because we have done this. We only need this master weapon. So in here, in hand, after doing this, let's just make some room here. Okay, I minimize it and open your gun models, whatever. I will open my third person, this one, the AK-47 model. So see that the pivot is here. As you can see, my pivot is here. So my gun attaching from this part. In Unreal Engine, you literally can't change your pivot. You can't. So what is the best way to do that? So you can see in here I have a socket manager. If you can't find a socket manager, just go to the Windows and make sure this socket manager is ticked. So let's create a socket and I'm gonna call it handle. Whatever you want to call it, just make it so handle with a H capital, and this handle should go something in here. Let me just turn off the snapping so I can set it. Hit F. Oops. Okay, so I am quite happy with, okay, this. Now go back to your master weapon. And from here, get your weapon mesh, static, dynamic, or skeletal, whatever, and get socket transform. If you get the socket transform, you can see the transform space in here. Now by default is set to world space, so it will give our world space transform whatever the world location, rotation, and scale it. But I want to make a local transform, so I will set it to RTS component. So I will get a local transform of my socket, and I will simply split this return value, right click to split it out. And I want this guy to set my relative location. Set relative location, yes, true, to wherever my socket is. So my socket will be on the different position. So this location should be multiply with minus. So it will give a minus value. So let's multiply with minus 1 and now attach it to here. I don't want to teleport or sweep it. So now if I open my this guy E, it is actually attached. Nope, it is not. Okay, we have to provide our socket name. The socket name is handle with H capital. Yes, now it should work probably. Work. Yes, as you can see, it is in my hand, exactly where it should be. So we have done all the equipment system. Let's add some inputs. So go to your settings, and on the project settings, you can see inputs in here. So let's add some inputs. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. First would be my one button so that I can open my pistol holster. So whatever my pistol holster is, I want to equip it. A second one would be my primary holster. So whatever in my primary holster, I want to equip that. And I simply want to call the function because we have already done all the things. So I will simply call a function. Then a third, if I hit 3, then my secondary weapon or secondary holster weapon would be equipped. So hit 3. If I hit 4, then my melee slot weapon would be equipped. So melee holster for the 4 button. And my for the 0, I don't want to equip anything. I want to sheath it. So if I hit a 0, then I want to sheath it. Just close this. Now, what is the best place to provide these inputs? Well, your player character would be fine. And also your player. So I will do for the player. So open your player character. If you want to do it for your player character, that's also fine. And I think this event graph, if we code our gun system in our event graph, then it will be too messy. So let's make another graph, and I'm gonna call it a weapon graph. So whatever our weapon code is, it will be coded in the weapon graph. So if you right click and search for the pistol holster, this input would be fine. Same if you search for the primary holster, a primary holster would be fine. Same for the secondary holster. So because we only have to call out a function, and same for the melee holsters. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, and fifth one is a sheath weapon, right? Sheath, yes. So we have 5 inputs. Now what? I want to call out these inputs based on a value. So how do we gonna do that? So first things first, let's make a function called equip a weapon. Equip a weapon, and this would be a 2 or 3 node weapon. And a equip weapon, I need a input called weapon input. This would be type of your inputs, E underscore weapon input. The reason I'm doing this is because I want to do it in the equipping part. So I want to use those animation I have downloaded. If you don't have animation, you have to call a function So for that, get your weapon system component. If you remembered, we have called that weapon input. Is this one? No, it wasn't this. I will simply open my weapon input so I can check weapon input, because we have created two functions. The can animate one, yes, this one, the can animate. I don't want this one to be a pure function, or can I? Yes, I can. So input anim or anim, yes, weapon type anim, this one, the weapon type, where it was, this guy. I want to call out this weapon type anim function, and this guy would go to here because it would be same for everything. Hit branch. So if my player can animate, then I want to play an animation montage. For that we need to create a montage. So where, open your animation wherever it was. Animations, nope, not this one, the combat animations. And my equipping weapon standing, this one would be fine. Okay, so as you can see, this is my best weapon animation. Okay, and let's see where it is actually equipping a weapon. Yes, this point, add this 26th or 7th, 26.41 frame, it is equipping a weapon. So at this point, I want to add a notifier. So you can see in the animation sequence, you can see a notifier. So let's add a notifier, a new notify, add a new, and I'm gonna call it n underscore equip. Let's save it. And okay, it is done. So close that. Now, open your animation blueprint wherever it was. I am using my basic third person animation blueprint. So as you can see, this is my basic third animation blueprint. Nothing I have done in here. So right click and search for that notifier we have just created, and underscore anim notifier equip. Right? If you can't find this notify, it means your animations, these are not using the same skeleton your player are using. So these animations and your player's animation both are using a different skeleton rig. So you have to retarget your skeleton, right click, and in here I retarget anim assets. You have to retarget, or you can watch any YouTube videos, they will show you how to retarget an animation. So if you can't find your animation notify, you have to retarget it. So whenever this anim notify would play, I will simply call that event, equip event. Simple. So for that, what I need, for that I first need to create a animation montage, right? In the combat mode, in the rifle equip standing, right click, and if you see this, create animation montage. I will create this montage, double click to open it up. It will simply open something like this. It's save, it compile and save this one. And in the third person character, simply you can see a new montage is added, which we have just created. Okay, now I need that function, the weapon function, weapon system. So how do you gonna do that? So you can see this is ticking every time. So just get the player owner, and I will simply cast to my third person or whatever the player character you are using. I'll simply cast it, and I will simply promote it, this one, to my player ref or player reference. we are doing this in an animation blueprint, right? So now I have my player reference, so I can use all the variables, all the function inside here. So I need a weapon component, system component. Let's get the weapon system component, and I need this equip event, the event in the event graph. Hit compile, save. So let's see if it's working or not. Oh wait, we have to call out this function, right? Because without that it won't work. So for the pistol also, I will simply call out this function and set this one to a pistol. For this one, it would be a rifle, a primary slot. For this guy, it would be a secondary slot. For this guy, melee holster, it would be a melee holster slot. And for this guy, it would be a sheath. So yeah, simply just, so let's just check out. Hit E, it is working. If I hit 0, nothing is happening. Why? Okay, let's check out this guy. So it is not happening. Oh yes, because we haven't setted this, we haven't blend this slot. We have to actually blend this slot, otherwise this animation montage won't gonna play. So go to your animation blueprint, and inside you will find an animation graph. So what I want to do, go to this state machine. This state machine is the default one, I haven't did anything. So I will simply disconnect this node, and from this what I will do, get default slot. Yes, get the default, and I will simply save this slot, and I'm gonna call this one a loco cache, whatever it is, you can call it whatever you want. Okay and this loco cache would go to here. Let's see, now it should work. If I hit 0, yes, it is actually working, but it is working very slow. So let me just go to your third person and in here, let me just set this play rate to 3. Okay, hit E, it's 0, it's now working for this guy. Yeah, hit 3. Well, it is not working. I don't know why. I will check. Okay, so let me just take where we messed up. Okay, so the problem was in this one, the weapon component input. Weapon type anim, this function, weapon type anim. So as you can see, we are equaling this weapon slot with the weapon input, but we actually want to equaling this with this guy E weapon, right? So I will right click and get E weapon, and I will hit control, and I will simply attach it to here. Because I want to check for the E weapon, this parameter, this one. Well, now it will work absolutely fine. Okay, it is working. Hit 2, I can do this, I can sheath it. Okay, it is working fine, it is working. Yeah, finally it is working. Let me just double check it. I don't want the access none for anyone. Okay, UMP gun, if I hit the UMP is swept. Okay, so I can carry any gun I want. Okay, so finally we have done the equipping part and the sheath part. So as you can see, you can simply pull out any gun and shoot it for 1, 2, 3. And as you can see, I have the third slot, and if I hit 3 again, nothing is happening. And I only have added the handle for my AK-47, so you can add a handle for every gun. So let's add a handle for my gun UMP. So UMP, so I will simply go to here in the socket manager. I will handle with H capital, and the handle would go something in here or something up. Hit save. So you can add handle for every gun, same I added for the AK-47. As you can see, if I hit E, the player is not changing the position, it is still in the idle position, but it should go in the combat mode. So we, in the next episode, we will do the combat mode and all the different states of animations, right? There is another one. So as you can see, if I run and if I hit 0, it is something called sliding, as you can see. So let's just, it's a simple fix. In your this combat mode, what I want to do, I want this guy, my player character, to only animate the upper part of the body. I don't want this guy to animate the lower part. So what I will do, I will go in the anim slot manager, and in here I will add a slot. I already have added a slot, but for you guys I will add it again. I can't delete it. Why? I should delete. Yes. So add a slot. There would be by default a default slot. I would add a new slot and call it upper part. So this upper part should be executed whenever I save it. And for this upper part, just set it to here. Okay. Let me just apply. So you cannot see in here, but it is working. Okay, and now I will simply close this up and open my animation blueprint, because I want to blend two animations. So where is my animation blueprint? This guy. So yeah, we have the loco cache, which is complete full body, and I want this guy to blend layer blend per bone, this one. So I want this whole animation to blend with my montage. So for that, what I will simply do, just make a little bit. So loco, get the loco cache, this one, and from that get default group. Yes, default slot group. And as you can see, this one is set to default slot. If you click on this, set it to the upper part, so that first we are getting the default slot loco cache, and then we will get the montage. And I will save this one to montage, or let's say upper part. So we have two saved caches. First is the full body, and second is the upper body. So full body would be blended with the upper part cache. And the weights would be 1. And in here, if you click on this one, you can see a layer setup. So add a branch, add an array, and I want to blend a bone from my this bone, this spine underscore 01. So from this to upper part, this will animate the second one, and from the lower part, it would animate the idle one. So this would be spine 1 underscore 01. Spine 1 with S small. Okay, and this guy would go simply in here. So let's check it out. Anything, if I run and if I hit C, as you can see, even if I running, it is working fine. Same with this gun, so I can call out any gun, and I will simply sheath it. I can equip, unequip any weapon I want. I can simply sheet heat. So you can see I can use this. We will do the blend spaces in the next video, but for this we are done with completing our weapon attachment system with 4 slots. So this is all for it now, and happy Diwali guys. So thank you so much guys for watching, and bye bye.